Hey YouTube, it's Nick Theos from Mikelson Yachts, and Sam and I are going to take you on a final walkthrough of Hyde, Awai, the Generation 2 Mikelson 43, hole number 94. We've been doing videos on this for the past couple weeks. We did some stuff on props that I'll talk to you about later on. But we want to do a nice detailed walkthrough before this one leaves San Diego and hits the East Coast where the owner's going to be playing on it. I am on the swim step. We have the optional swim step rails, which are great for tying a dinghy up to, for fishing off of. I want to release a fish. I feel real safe out here. There is a swim ladder right here. Telescopes. Pulls out. Get back up onto the boat safely. You want to always make sure that that's locked into place when you're running. You don't want to be dragging that around. That's not good for your performance. This boat has what's called the Glendenning Cable Master. So I press a button. There's a big bucket in here inside the engine room, and the Glendenning pulls that in and coils it up in the bucket, and you don't need to handle your shore cord and find a place to put it. It just sucks it back into the boat every time you hit the dock. Cool feature. Okay, I'm in the cockpit now. We just left the swim platform. This does not have a teak deck that you'll notice. Teak deck's an option. This is non-skid. We've got teak aisle boxes. When you build a 43, you can pick what storage capacity you want here. This one's got this cool little trash can. And this is a little locker here. Teak aisle does a bunch of cool stuff. We've got fresh and salt water wash down. I think my pump's on. Yep. But a half turn is wide open, which is really nice, as opposed to kind of like a spigot. You want full pressure all the time. We did a dockside water inlet here, so when he's at the slip, he can plug a hose into the boat and have water pressure. Here's the controls for that Glendenning Cable Master. Hot cold shower. I can shower off here. I can shower off on the swim step after I swam. I need to keep a bar of soap or a little shampoo in this locker too. Fish box. This can be a much bigger fish box. I can glass in a whole insulated box here. This is just an insert. I got a lot of options what you do with here for if I want to be able to store fish there or gear, what I want to do. We can be real custom here. The famous Mikelson cockpit table. Easily goes up and down for cocktail hour. Or a buffet, or whatever your table needs are. Then we have a day head on this one. You've seen on most of them. We did plumb air from the salon into this one. This one's gonna be on the East Coast, it's hotter. Another shower in here. And then we've talked about this a lot. This has the freshwater flush option. So if my water pump's on, I go to port, and that's gonna flood all those coolers full of fresh water. So every time I leave the boat, I don't want salt to be sitting in those coolers and rotting everything out. All that calcium and all that salt in there. So we're gonna flush all that stuff out and leave our engines full of fresh water when we leave the boat. Cockpit repeater. Let's get to take a picture of a camera image. Sink. I like this ambassador faucet we've done on this one. Comes out here. Got no shortage of handheld showers in this cockpit. Storage. Stainless steel door. Really nice, robust door. It's not going anywhere, it's not going to leak. Looks good. Over here, this has the Pro Pilot system. This is another Glendenning product that allows my bow thruster to work with my transmissions, and I can make the boat go sideways, back the boat up. Joystick control, but you don't have to do it with pods these days. You can do it with a conventional drive. another teak aisle locker. This has some tackle storage, a place for your knife and some pliers. That's the cockpit. All right, now I'm down in the engine room. Starboard engine, great access. Onan generators right here. This is an option. This is called a buck boost transformer. This is gonna take my dockside voltage and boost it up to 220 volts or 240 volts. If I'm in Mexico or I'm somewhere where my power's down at 208 or something, that's not very good for my appliances. This is gonna bring it up to the proper voltage for the boat. This boat has two AGM start batteries. It's got a lithium ion house battery that we'll talk about later, but my two AGM house batteries, start batteries, sorry, are back here. They have their own chargers. And then, where am I going with this?
What else? We can show them the fuel filters in the center. We can show them all the...
Power steering.
Oh, yeah, yeah, we have power steering on this one too. All right, we're gonna hop over really quick, YouTube.
Okay, so now I'm over on the port side of the engine room. Sam's gonna hop down and show you the forward bulkhead of the engine room. So what you're seeing up above are our battery switches. I've got port engine, generator windlass, starboard engine, house battery across there. The port one, they're all on 1+2, so they're using both of our start AGM 8D batteries that are back here. The idea here is that I'm separating my house bank and my start bank. I can always start my engines, my generator, my windlass, and pick up my anchor if I were to completely run my my house bank dry. Below that, the fuel manifold are all those red valves. Below that, I've got start stops, and I've got Cummins engine gauges for both my port and starboard motors.
Sorry, one more thing. But each one of these is labeled to where it goes.
Yeah, you're going to draw from one side and return to the other side. On a diesel boat, you return to the fuel tanks as well. Main engine seacock for your port starboard engine.
Tell them about the little sensor.
The little sensor, that is part of a siren system. So the owner can monitor the bilge pumps, the shore power. I think that's all we've got it set up for. The temperature of the boat from his cell phone anywhere he's at on Earth. And that set up the high water alarm, and then he'll get a text or some kind of notification if his high water alarm goes off when he's out on the boat.
Cool. Awesome.
Back here we've got our power steering. This is a Dometic power steering system. There's a ram for each rudder. This attaches. Here's my rudder post right here. And this goes up to the reservoir. It's hydraulic, and you get you can steer this boat with your pinky. Pretty slick.
Awesome.
Back here I've got another bilge pump, and this one we didn't attach to the siren system, because no, the forward one, far. Yeah, we didn't need to. Here's my plumbing for my bait system. This is my inlets. This is my out. And here's the bait pump. You want it to come up nice and evenly. You don't want it to dip down. You'll get air in there.
And again, all of our hoses, two air conditioner forward. Two bait pumps, so you're not just guessing what this through hole goes to. It tells you right there.
And the location of the C-strainers. I mean, you can actually get to this one. So many builders put them over in some corner somewhere you can't get to. And if this clogs with eelgrass, I gotta be able to get to this to clean this out.
Oh, tell them about the bucket.
Here's the bucket for the Glendenning we talked about before. So you can see the motor. I can turn it on, you can see it, reel it in. Zoom in on that.
Kind of tangled up. We'll get that figured out.
There's my port side start battery. And down here is the through hole for the day head. You can go directly overboard out there, or you can send it to your holding tank if you're offshore.
Yeah.
Close enough.
We got it. All right, heading inside?
Let's go inside. All right, welcome aboard. Welcome into the salon. This is the customer's second 43 he built, so we had some real definite ideas on what he wanted to do on this one that are different from his first 43. Countertops, some nice granite countertops, no sea rail. We veneered the fridge. You see a lot of our fridges that are a stainless steel finish. He wanted to blend with the rest of the cherry in the boat, so we factored a great job veneering the face of the refrigerator. We did this kind of cool custom towel paper locker here. Customer drew it up, we sent it to the factory and they built it. As we end up over here, electrical panel. This is my AC side, this is our 12 volt side.
This one's a little different because the house battery reset for the lithium ion.
We'll show you that, that's under the salon.
And then it tells you like what percentage that lithium ion battery is at. Cool.
Entertainment center, we did the U-line ice maker here and we put it on a track. So as I open this, there's a track right here, it opens the door for you. We'll have to open two doors. My chase lounge and my settee, this drops down. I've got the burl inlay in here, in the tabletop. And then over here, we've never done this. So usually this is a couple barrel chairs or a whole settee. We did some bar stools, but we built this little bench that worked out really well. Just a short bench here, you can sit here, I can watch TV. I ended up with this cool area here for his beer cooler and wine locker. And I still have a settee here. Worked out really well. And then back in the galley, we put a vent here. So when he's cooking bacon or whatnot, we can pull all those fumes and blow them right outside. Fusion speakers in the ceiling. Rod locker. Oh, look at that. Light comes on, light comes off. Forward.
I'll follow you.
Boom. All right, galley, or galley, head. There's my davit post, the sandpipe comes down into here and secures this bulkhead. Did a nice backsplash on this one in the head. And then the shower door does that in wood trim.
Oh yeah, I forgot about that.
A little cleaner look. This is definitely the first time I've done this on a guest stateroom. You're used to seeing a single Pullman that flips down. We did a little bunk over here that will be used more for storage, but I've got a nice big double here. Then I've got this really nice storage locker that a kid can also sit on, storage shelf.
Nice.
Forward. Queen bird. Extra ventilation from the air conditioner. Again, East Coast boat, it's gonna be hot over there. We're gonna blow air all over the place, this master, and keep it cool.
Cool.
Under salon, we got 24 inch wide washer dryer. That's a vented 220 volt dryer. Lots of space down here, you can do that. There's my fresh water pump and my my UV filter and fresh water filter.
And your salt water pump.
Salt water pump's over there as well. This is my sump. So my shower dumps into this, and then whenever this box fills up, it dumps it overboard. You can get to it through here if you need to clean it out every year or so. Storage. And as we swing over here, this is the lithium ion battery. This is 450 amp hours, I think. I think that's the one we did on this boat. Hot water heater. There is a soft hatch here if you need to open this up to do some real work down here. Magnum inverter / charger. Box of wine over there. And then here's my center bilge pump, and this has another siren monitor on it. I'll tell you if your bilge pump's on. Nice. That's the under salon.
Thank you.
right, Sam just brought you up the stairs, no ladder, up to the flybridge on the Mikelson 43. We're gonna walk you through the forward helm first. Starting on the starboard side, another teak owl product. We did a little glove box. We put a little charger in there, so you can put your phone in there and charge it, and there are your devices. VHF radio, spotlight, engine controls, trim tabs, autopilot, steering wheel with tilt, set of Garmin screens. So this is set up with a plotter right now, but I can do vessel. I can bring up all kinds of data on my engines right here.
Cool.
We got start stops, control gauges for both engines. The depth sounder's brought up on this Garmin screen. Again, here's another ProPilot joystick, so I can have a joystick at the forward station. And when my controls are active, I can use this left and right as a bow thruster. So if I'm not in joystick mode, I can just use my bow thruster.
Show them their cool cup.
I don't know what it is.
Oh, he like had to have this cup. So he said that on his last boat, he left it in the sink and it got so hot in the sink that it started melting.
Oh, wow, look at that.
But he was cracking me up because he said they don't make them anymore and it's magnetic so you don't lose your drink.
Oh, I see. Very cool.
Had to have that.
Learning something new. Sink, overhead lights, anchor, and the Mikelson alarm panel. Test if you got a fire or a high water alarm. That's your forward station.
Cool.
Big stud helm seats. These are the high backs. He wants to be able to kick back and have a headrest.
Let's get a demonstration of that real quick.
Absolutely.
Oh, that's nice right there. Full relaxation.
See you, Mai Tai.
Looking good.
Behind me is a beautiful teak table. Standard would be a fiberglass table, but the teak is definitely fancier. It looks really good. And we've got our settee. Table does come down and convert to another berth. And then my aft station. Again, I've got controls. I've got another ProPilot joystick. And you need to put just a regular bow thruster controller somewhere. So we stuck it back here. And you need a display screen for the power steering. So we put that back here as well. Aft station, backing into a slip, fighting a fish. We'll be right here. Although I could be in the tower when I'm backing into a slip as well. We'll take you up there next. Okay, so the ladder to get up to the bridge, this used to go this way, and we rotated at 90 degrees, which was a really smart maneuver. Richard, there's a shout out to you for this idea. Worked out really, really well. It's out of the way, and it's just as easy to get up to the tower. Here we are up in the tower. We got a nice bench seat here. My sat TV dome sits off the back, looks really clean. I've got a wheel. Controls, start stops, and then we did a 10-inch Garmin screen up here as well. So it's on plotter right now, or actually it's on sounder, it's on fisheye. But I can, you know, if I want to bring in my depth sounder because I'm up here fishing.
Cool.
All the same information that come up there. And from here, I feel really comfortable controlling the boat. I can look down and see that, look forward. I can see my bow so well. Nice place to run the boat from.
Awesome. We'll take them up forward, show them the bow.
Let's take them forward, show them the fancy davit. Okay, heading up to the bow. I'm going to show you how nice our walk-arounds are. I believe there is 13 inches wide width of tread right here. Plenty of room to get up here. I've got handrails on both sides. Feel real comfortable going forward and real safe. This is an E1000 steelhead. Auto rotate davit, auto luffing, auto extending. Does it all.
Show us.
Mode out.
Show us how that works.
Link it. Let's see. Let's extend. Boom. slack?
Give me a little slack.
Perfect. Okay, now we're gonna go. So up. And we'll go towards Sam. Towards me, actually. We can extend. We can boom. This makes launching your davit super, super easy. Once you go out of rotate, it's hard to go back. Besides the cool davit, we've got our D-rings. All the 43s come with these, whether you're gonna do a dinghy and davit initially or not, and these are through bolted. These aren't going anywhere. So if you add a dinghy later on, you're not digging into your headliner to through bolt your tie downs to lash your dinghy up here.
Awesome. Anchor locker?
Anchor locker. There's that spotlight we talked about. It's all Mikelson's. We're hiding our windlass up here in this four-deck hatch locker. It's not up here when I'm fishing, when I'm using the bell pulpit to pretend like I'm in Titanic. It's out of the way. It's down here. I've got fresh and salt wash down here. We did these cool drains on this one, which we should do on all of them, because usually these scuppers just drain into the anchor locker and eventually they'll get down into your chain locker. But this is a direct route, so this isn't as wet in here. Good place to store extra fuel for your dinghy, fenders, stuff like that. You've got controls at the forward flybridge helm that we showed you, and then you've also got foot pedals up here to deploy and retrieve the anchor.
All right, DiCaprio, give us the send-off.
So the one last thing I want to talk about was the props. We had a couple ask us about the props, because some of our previous videos, we were taking props off, we were putting them back on, especially Jim and Big Bear, you asked me. So 26 by 26 diameter props are standard for the 43. That means 26 is the diameter of the props and 26 is also the pitch of each blade, four blades. We tried some Veeam 5-blade 26 by 23s with interceptors that we could change the pitch, but it didn't work out the first time. We were overloading the motors and we weren't improving our performance. So we put the 26 by 26s back on. Veeam's gonna crunch those numbers and we'll see what else they come up with. But that was all that back and forth we did with the props was, you know, we're always trying to get the best performance we can out of the boat. That's it. This is hole number 4394. It was a long road. She's all done, heading east. And we'll have 4395 here before you know it. Adios.